Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to GovBerg, and thanks for logging on. Today, we're looking at the Jaeger LeCoultre Master Control Date. You can see the stainless steel black dial 2015 SIHH novelty on our website, govbergwatches.com. And if you enjoy these videos, please subscribe to our app, GovBerg On Time, for the latest news, views, reviews, and videos of luxury watches. Now, on my wrist, 16 centimeters in circumference, 6.3 inches, this SIHH 2015 novelty might have the most visual impact of any watch JLC unveiled that year. 39 millimeters across the round of the case. It's also nice and slim, measuring only 9 millimeters thick with a conical bezel. It actually functions practically thinner than that. Sliding underneath a dress cuff, it also has a slightly cupped case back, so it nestles into the wrist. It winds up wearing like a much thinner watch, perhaps one even as thin as 7 millimeters. Now, from lug to lug, it is quite compact. JLC reins in the lugs to the tune of 47 millimeters from lug to lug, but it has a nice tripartite appearance to it. Being that the case isn't oversized, JLC is able to extend the lugs, giving them a graceful arc down and away around the flanks of the wrist, such that the watch does have the bezel, the case, and the lug features that I consider the tripartite elements of watch styling. Now, the strap is an interesting choice on two levels. First, there are semi-conforming spring bars, so they do trace the arc of the case, so there's visual congruence there, but they don't pin themselves against the flank of the case. So if you want to pull the strap down around the tight curve of a smaller wrist, you can easily do so. This is a watch that's friendly probably for wrists as small as 13.5-14 centimeters in circumference. You can also see that the lightly bolstered strap uses a matte finish, not quite as formal as the usual shiny alligator scales. This makes the watch a bit more versatile, such that it can easily be paired with short sleeves and short pants. Nevertheless, the combination of a black dial and white metal makes the watch incredibly striking, and it is, if you want it to be, the quintessential watch for the most formal of occasions. And yet, it does have that casual steel sports watch vibe to it. Now, it may have the heart of a sports watch, but it definitely has the clasp of one. You can see that it features a gorgeous stainless steel double deployant. It's very convenient. This has been the standard for JLC since 2006. It gives you the ergonomic excellence of a double fold, so you don't have that one big up and over that can cause a single fold to pinch skin if you're buckling it down to the lower limits. That can sometimes be a pain on a smaller wrist. This is never a pain, as it closes in two small steps. Now, the watch features a gorgeous case that really minimizes the impact of bezel and flanks to maximize the impact of the dial. Now, black dials have been coming back in the JLC catalog over the last 2 years, and this one is one of the most striking. Although 2015 saw the brand unveil its usual lineup of grand complications and high art pieces, this simple steel watch with a matte black dial and a combination of white metal and gorgeous white gold indices and hands might be the most charismatic timepiece the Grand Maison debuted that year. And this is why. It's legible, it's handsome, it's classically proportioned, it has a gorgeous proportion to it. It also has a gorgeous balance to it. Now, all of the printing is silver, matte silver on matte black, so it doesn't explode in gaudy fashion the way a sunburst or a lacquered dial can. It's subdued, it's always a soft glow, it's always a slow burn. All of the dart indices are faceted, so they do have a little bit of a tendency to twinkle in the light, but the Dauphine hands at center are actually half frosted, so that no matter what light you see them in, they always allow for legibility at a glance. That's one of the reasons the matte dial makes the watch more practical. There's no tendency of a gleaming metal part to blend into the gleam of the dial. Now, moreover, the watch is fully lumed, as each hour index features an outboard luminescent dot, and each of the Dauphine hands at center does feature a narrow strip of luminova. There's also a beautiful monotone date disc with the same silver print for the number font. Balance, charisma, power, that's what you get here. On the back side, you get tried and true in-house JLC watchmaking savoir-faire. Now, this is the caliber 899, 32 jewels, over 200 parts. It is free-sprung, so it has a built-in resistance to shock-induced timing variations. Again, a little bit of that sports watch DNA finding its way into the dress range. Now, the Master Control in 1992 introduced the 1,000 hours control concept. JLC's fully cased up 40-plus day chronometry trial in which the watch is subjected to tests of power reserve, resistance to magnetism, tests of water resistance, tests of shock resistance, everything that a watch can experience on the wrist, essentially packed into a month plus of rigor. Now, this one features both the free sprung balance and a double laser welded hairspring at the stud and the collet for additional resilience. Unidirectional winding, it features a higher grade 22 carat gold winding mass. Many have stepped back to 21 or 18. JLC retains a very massive winding mass for higher efficiency in conjunction with those ceramic rotor bearings. Now, it has about a 45 hour power reserve, and it does feature hacking seconds, so if you pull the crown, you do stop the balance and allow precise synchronization to a known accurate reference time. There's also a quick set function for the date, so should the watch run down or should you encounter an irregular length month, you can quickly correct it. This is a ton of watch for the money, but beyond that, it's a watch with a persona that simply punches above its weight and above its price point. This is the kind of watch that can steal the stage from a Grand Comp at your next Red Bar meet. You can see it and you can buy it on our website, govbergwatches.com.